let's learn some quick division techniques. So before we move further, let us divide 25 by 10. So if I have to divide 25 by 10, I will write 25 here and 10 here. So 10 multiplied by 2 is 20, and I will get 5 as the remainder, right? 5 is the remainder and 2 is my quotient. Okay, so I will write here quotient is 2 and remainder is 5. Okay, I'm writing quotient first because it is the main answer and remainder is what is left. Now let's divide 135 by 10. So 10 ones are 10. 35, 10 threes are 30 and it is 5. So again, what is the quotient? Quotient is 13 and remainder is 5. If you see carefully, the last digit is the remainder. This is the last digit, 5, it is the remainder. And quotient is this 2. Here, the last digit is the remainder, that is 5. And quotient is 13. Let us see if it happens every time or this it is the case with these two numbers only. Right, let's divide 2934 by 10. So first we will see that 29 comes here or not. So 29 does not come in the table of 10. So 10 29 se chota kya hoga? What will be less than 29? It will be 20. 10 ones are 10, 10 twos are 20, which will be near. So we will take 10 multiplied by 2 is 20. So 9. Then we will take 3. It will become 93. Then 10 nines are 90. 10 tens are 100. 100 we cannot take. So 10 nines are 90 we will take because it is less than and it is closer to 93. Now 3 will come and we will take down 4. Now this is 34, so 10 multiply by 3 is 30, and how much is left? 4. So that means 293 is our quotient and this is our remainder, right? So this is our quotient and this is our remainder. Now let's do another question. 14,738 divided by 10. So 10 ones are 10. 4, I take down 7. It becomes 47. So 10 fours are 40. Now 47 minus 40 is 7 and I take down 3. So 10 sevens are 70. Now I take down 8. So this becomes 38. Now 10 threes are 30 and we get the remainder 8. Again, what is the quotient? What is the main answer? 1473. This is our quotient and this is our remainder. Okay, so this is our quotient and this is our remainder. Let's do some practice. So remember, the 0 is determining the remainder. So we will see how many 0. 1 0, so one digit remainder. This is 5. 5 will be remainder and rest will be my quotient. So my quotient is 2974. Now again 1 0, one digit, last digit is my remainder and this will be my quotient. 8 3 7 4, that is 8374. Again I am dividing by 0, so sorry, I am dividing by 10. 1 digit, 1 0, 1 last digit, so my remainder is 0 and my quotient is 9080, that is 9080. Let's see. Oh my god, this is a very big number, but we can do it very quickly. So it is 10. We know 1 0, that means last digit is will be the remainder. So this will become, the remainder will become 5 and this will be our quotient. Okay, So 50 50 50 is our quotient. So this is our answer. 5,05,050 is our quotient. Okay, last trick which I am going to tell you, listen very carefully. If you forget which is quotient and which is remainder, remember in A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, that means alphabetically Q comes before R or R comes before Q. Tell me. Q comes before R, so that means Q will come before R. And R is the remainder, it is the left out. So this 0 is determining how many are left out. Okay, so always remember this, remainder is the last one. Jo bachega wo last mein hoga. Remainder hamesha kya hota hai, jo bach gaya to wo hamesha bacha hua last ka last wale digit ke according hoga. And quotient jo queen hai, jo aage hai, wo aage hoga. Answer is the queen, quotient. So that will be in the beginning. Now same rule is applied when we divide by 100. Again, how many zeros? Two zeros. So, two digit remainder and this will become our quotient. So, 47 will be our quotient and 38 will be our remainder. Now, this is two zeros. So, two digit remainder, 95. And what will be the quotient? The quotient will be 291. Similarly, this is divided by 100. Two zeros. So, two digit remainder, that is 08, or we can write simple 8 because 08 is 8 only. And how much is left? 300. So, 300 is our quotient. Okay. Now, in this again two zeros. So, two digit remainder, that is 19. And this is, what is the quotient? 1910, that is 1910. Again, two zeros, two digit remainder, 81. And the left one, the which is there in the beginning, that is 30030, that is 30,030 is the quotient. And let's move to the last one, two zeros. So this is our remainder, that is nothing is our remainder, zero, and this will be my quotient. So 9999 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5. So 99,999 is our quotient. It's very simple. Same thing is the case with when we divide by 1000. Three digits, three zeros, three digit remainder. So 519 is the remainder and this is our quotient. Three is our quotient. Three zeros, so three digits. So this is 015, or you can say simple 15 is our remainder and 15 is again our quotient. And again last three zeros, so three digits, 953 is our remainder and this is our quotient. If you forget, I repeat, if you forget ki what is quotient, what is remainder, aage aata hai, peeche aata hai, hamesha yaad rakhna ki quotient Q jo hai R se pehle aata hai. Jab aap ABCD bolte hai to Q pehle aata hai aur R uske baad mein aata hai. To isliye quotient pehle aayega, R baad mein aayega. Par pehle aapko R determine karna, you have to determine what is R, what is remainder. For that you have to see 000. This rule applies whenever we divide by 10, 100 or 1000. Okay? Now you try yourself.